My name is Dr. Mbira Gikonyo, and I've partnered with Ponea Health to bring information in the area of ear, nose and throat. I'm an ENT surgeon specializing in diseases of the ear, of the nose and of the throat. And today we want to talk about the ear and infections of the ear and problems of the ear. One of the commonest problems of the ear is earwax. And one of the things that we advise people is that generally to leave their ears alone. Part of the reason why people end up with wax stuck in the ear is because they shove in almost every morning a cotton bud into the ear. Then whatever wax was coming out by itself is pushed back in. Then eventually it accumulates and blocks the ear completely. And that can also result in infection. The ear knows how to clean itself. If you leave it alone, it'll be fine. You can live up to 100 years and never ever need your ear to be cleaned if you don't disturb your ear. So it's better not to disturb your ear. Even worse, some people put in cotton buds into the ear and then they forget and they go to answer their phone and they burst the eardrum, which is bad for them. It's good for our business, but we prefer if you don't put that into your ear. If you decide to clean your ear, be very, very careful. Clean it and finish and throw away that cotton bud. Don't walk around with it. Somebody can even hit onto your hand in error as you walk around, you know, scratching your ear with a cotton bud. So generally keep off cotton buds. Now, when it comes to further ear infections are most common in childhood because of something we call the eustachian tube. There is a tube between the nose and the ear, which takes air from the nose to the ear. In children, that tube is more open and more flat than in adults. So if a child is actually breastfeeding at an angle, some of the breast milk can end up going to the ear, or even some of the milk from a bottle can go to the ear, and that can result in ear infections. Then, of course, when a child is going to school, especially when they begin school, they often come home with ear infections because they've gone to school and they've come across some other children with some very strange bugs, viruses, bacteria of all sorts, who've come to school coughing with running noses. And this child who's not been exposed to other children before picks it up. And sometimes that infection spreads from the nose to the ear and then causes a severe infection that we call otitis media. In some other cases, of course, children can put foreign things into their ears, they can put seeds, or sometimes people are unlucky, even an insect can get into the ear and contribute to infections which require to be treated. Of course, apart from the common infections, is what we call bacterial infections. There are others which are due to viruses, and all this can be a real challenge. Bacterial infections can even erode or affect the bones of the ear, leading to deafness. They can even go to what we call the mastoid bone, the bone behind the ear, and can cause swelling in the bone. They can make the ear swell and move forward and even have something we call abscess or accumulate pus, which has to be removed. So all these are the various possibilities and infections which affect the ear. Ear infections have to be attended to urgently and early. Never ignore an ear infection. The reason, there are many reasons, but one of them is that the nerve for smiling, the nerve for closing your eye, the nerve for closing your mouth actually passes through the ear. If you get a severe ear infection, that nerve can be crippled, or you can end up with something we call facial palsy. And one side of your face becomes paralyzed. You can't close your mouth, you can't close your eyes, even when you're asleep. And people look at you, look like you've had a stroke. So it's very important to treat the ear infection before it gets out of control. In some other people, the infection goes to what we call the vestibular system of the ear. The vestibular system of the ear is a part of the ear that is responsible for balance. Then you can find a young man who cannot walk because that part of the ear is destroyed. He tries to walk, he collapses, or the ground looks like it's moving because of that infection, what we call labyrinthitis, which can also lead to nausea, to vomiting, and can be very, very disruptive to somebody's life. And then some people end up with inner ear problems. You can end up with the ear bones melting away or being eroded away. Then somebody becomes permanently deaf and they require operations, or they require hearing aids, or they require cochlear implants to enable them to hear again. But if the ear infection is addressed early, if it is treated early, then you can avoid all those problems, which we call complications of infection. So anything wrong with the ear, see your ear doctor as early as possible, get it treated, and you'll recover at a low cost and you'll do well. When you try and restore the nerve, it's very, very hard. When you try and buy a hearing aid, it's expensive. If you become permanently deaf, it's miserable for one's life and for one's career. So I would urge that if there's an ear problem, have it addressed early so that the problem can be solved as soon as it is possible. Thank you. Thank you very much for joining us for this discussion. You can book our services at ponea.com, and we look forward to welcoming you another time for another discussion. Thank you very much.